Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and as always, thank you for watching. This is going to be a test run on a new dash cam that my wife bought me. A lot of my viewers were saying they were having trouble seeing and having trouble seeing with my GoPro on my helmet while I was driving, and it was also bouncy and my head moving all the time, which I do understand. So we're going to try this nice little dash cam that my wife got me and see how it works. Thank you to my lovely wife, and hopefully this will take care of some of the bouncing around problems. I don't know what the sound quality is going to be like, but the picture quality I have tested, and it appears to be pretty good. So now on to the business at hand. As always, thank you for watching. We've been called by a customer to pick up a truck and a loaded trailer from a facility after the driver has run out of hours and the facility will not allow him to remain on premises until his hours come back up. So we have to tow the truck and the loaded trailer to a quote safe haven, which in this instance will probably be a truck stop that's about 8 miles or so from where the tractor and trailer currently are. So I'm just going to be quiet and drive. Let's see how well this thing records, and we'll go from there. I have tried this camera out before today's filming. By the way, today is July 13th, 2017, approximately 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. But I have tried this camera out, just a few test runs, just to see how it's going to look on the screen. And I can tell you that, especially at night, this camera picks up a lot more light than my GoPro has been picking up. I know that a lot of my night videos are very, very dark. This dash cam picks up a lot at night. So hopefully that will be a major improvement for you guys. Okay, we're almost to our pickup location. Thought of something while I was driving. I had a viewer call and asked how to subscribe to my channel. So for those of you who may not be aware of how to subscribe to my channel, if you would like to subscribe to my channel, if you're using a phone, a tablet, a computer, or some smart TVs even, on the bottom right hand side of your screen there should be a little red subscribe button. All you have to do is click on that little subscribe button and you're subscribed to my channel, and you'll get notifications when I upload new videos. I would appreciate a subscription. That would be great. Also, please feel free to share my videos on your Facebook or whatever other forms of media you choose, but you're welcome to share my videos. I appreciate all of my viewers. So here should be our entry location. that I can hear through the intercom. Yes, Glenn, my name is Ron with Midwest Truck. I'm at the entry gate. I'm supposed to have a U.S. Express truck and trailer that I have to tow out of here.
Okay. Do you know where it is?
No, sir. They did not give me his location other than he is in Mondi at this address. And where would that be, sir?
That's up on 61. But let me make sure before I send you out of here.
Okay, that's the newer facility down towards Jackson, correct?
You got it, man. You got it. Yes, sir.
Okay.
I think that's where he's at, but let's find out, okay?
Yes, sir.
I don't care who you are.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Alright, I don't know if you can hear the whole conversation. This particular facility has several locations. They believe that the driver may be at a different location, but they have allowed me to come in through the gate and search for the driver. Told me to come in and find out if he's in here. If not, we'll go out through the exit and go down to the other facility. Alright, again, I'm here by the talk box. I need to shut the truck off so I can hear. Actually, sir, I believe I see him outside of your gate down here at the three-way stop.
Okay. At 170. What's your name?
My name is Ron with Midwest Truck.
All right, I'll let you out, buddy.
Thank you very much, sir. May not be the one I'm looking for, but there is a U.S. Express truck and trailer down here sitting off the edge of the road. Back up a little though, so not blocking the intersection. Pull up behind him first and make sure we've got the right unit. put my hard hat with my GoPro on. And we're gonna switch to it. I'm gonna turn the dash cam off and we're gonna go to hard hat. Just making sure you're the one I'm after. Run out of hours?
Yep.
All right, okay, good deal. Yeah, what I should have done was taken my light bar and hooked it up to the trailer before I moved. But I didn't, so we'll make it. This is not a highly traveled road, but you still want to be cautious. It only takes one time. Loaded?
45.
45, okay.
No, not 45. 35.
35, okay. Still a pretty healthy load.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, watch your back. If you don't mind, either stand on the other side or you're welcome to sit up in my truck and cool off, whatever. I'll take care of all this. Alright. Make sure that. Okay. Oh, shoot. I didn't know that. I don't have room for two people. I'll have to get somebody coming to, because I can't have you in anyone in the vehicle that I'm towing. But we'll get that taken care of. I'll get somebody coming.
Hey, Lynn. Let me talk to Mom or Lauren, please. Hey, Lauren. I need some help. Alright. The truck that I was sent up here to tow has a driver and a passenger. I have nowhere to legally put a passenger. Yep. I need somebody to come up, if they would, and pick up at least one, if not both. I am at past PNG. At the I'm at the PNG main facility. You can't miss me. You go past the drop lot and go to the T where 177 cuts back in towards Cape, or you go straight and you go right into the PNG plant itself. But I'm right there at the T, past the PNG drop lots. You can't miss me. Okay. Okay, hon. All right, babe. Thank you. All right, bye. Fortunately, they've got a pretty good view. People can see me. So I'm not gonna have to run cones as far down as I normally would. They must have had shift change or something, because we got quite a few cars coming out now. Hey guys, what's up? Straight liner hooks, because I know I'm gonna have to lift it to pick it. Come back a little bit. Okay, that's fine. All right, then. All right, thank you. Bye. Winches free spooled. Unlock the carriage. Roll the boom. the axle down in the underreach and keeps it from shifting side to side. A cooler day to do this, you know? I said that with a smile on my face. I was being sarcastic. They knew it. I was just joking. Tough ones, but it's all right. Get some straps to hang the shaft. Shut it off for a minute while I pull the drive shaft out.
I have the tractor brakes on.
Okay, yeah, I'll get all that taken care of. Thank you, though. It's one that I may not have to lay on the ground for. That's good. One. There we go. That's it.
Nope, it's going to be stubborn. Dang it. Oh well, you get those every now and then. Vamp, you need to sit up in my truck and cool off. You're more than welcome to. You're more than welcome to. I'm sorry?
You're getting aggravated.
Oh. A viewer send me this nice gear ratchet set after seeing me have difficulties putting a T-bolt in a spring brake chamber. You know who you are, and I am very grateful. We'll have you moving here shortly. This won't take very long, especially since it runs. Go get broke loose. Okay. Break that one loose. Dang it. Big bar time.
Nope, nothing to pry off of there. Come on. That son of a gun just does not want to give it up.
Push my red air supply in, tricking my truck into thinking I've got it hooked up. Pull slowly forward first, trolley valve down, brakes holding, and we're in good shape. Turn the helmet cam off while I drive. Need to cool down some. gentlemen, we are almost back to the truck stop, safe haven, where we're going to drop this semi. Go through this one stoplight. It'll be down on our left. And I'll have to try to find a place to either back it in and then drop it out, or drop it out, put the drive shaft back in it, and then drop it in. One of the two. Either way, the drive shaft's got to go back in it. Need to be in this, in the left-hand lane up here, but I'm taking the right-hand lane because I'm so long and I need a very wide swing out to make this curve without getting into oncoming traffic. We'll just have to go slow and let these other people slide on past us. There we go. Talon's running behind us. So we move right on over, and we're good.
stuff that he can straighten it out a little bit if he needs to. Alright. Now to reverse the process.
Must be Leanne setting the phone. Hello? Okay. Alright, thanks. Bye. You don't have to do this. If you want to go, go ahead. Let me get the boom on it and put that, yeah, there you go, switch that around. My bad. See the remote, it shifted a little bit. All I needed. Thank you. Talon's going to get the light bar for me. Down safe and sound. Forward, but we went up to 9. We don't want to be at 9. Come back down. There we go, 8 degrees. Alright. Raise some outriggers. Just about missed it. Yep. Lifting eyes. Get the bolts. I got side cutters. They're back there.
Thank you.
Yep. Got the U-joint strap bolts. Off.
side.
You're all right. On this one.
We'll put your stock cutters up in the toolbox there.
All right, thank you.
Yes, sir. Where does your big airline go?
Front box, driver's side. Putting blue Loctite, which is medium strength Loctite, back on the drive shaft bolts. Battery's going down. This drive shaft.
I'll make sure you get this in.
Finishes up. No, that's it. I gotta get the paperwork and then I'm done.
Heck yeah.
Thanks for coming out and getting them.
Oh yeah. Anytime. Come on, head on home.
Alright, appreciate it.
Yeah, be careful.
No, thank you. I got stuff in the truck. Say it's all done but the paperwork. You can start it back up, cool it down now. I'm done under here. All right, sir. She's all yours, ready to go. Thank you, sir. Get you some rest.
That's what I plan on.
All right, bud. Be safe out there. As always, thank you for watching. God bless.